Hey, my name's Charlie. Sometimes I like to work out. I think I've made some pretty good progress over the last few years, and like most of you, fitness is something that I just do for fun. I don't make money from it. I don't have things like a personal chef, a crazy home gym, or other resources that someone like The Rock might have. The people that do have those resources are the ones who absolutely dominate the industry. This can give the rest of us, like me, unrealistic expectations for what our progress in the gym should look like. So, I'm here to show you what the truly average guy's progress looks like. Someone with no enhancements, pretty average genetics, and someone who doesn't dedicate his life to the gym. Today, I'm going to be showing you a short little push workout in my grimy basement home gym, or as I like to call it, the rat cave. So this is my home gym. It's probably about as old as I am. Got some dumbbells over here, attachments for the pull-down machine, interchangeable dumbbells, old-ass speakers, and a mirror that I like to flex in sometimes. So I like to start out with a little bench press, do a little bit of stretching, and by a little bit I mean pretty much nothing. So real quick, I always like to warm up with just the bar. I do something like 10 or 15 reps just to get my form down and get the blood flowing. Nice and easy warm up. Then we're gonna go ahead and slap some 25s on there for 95 pounds. Still just warming up. My bench press sucks. I'm not even gonna deny it, not gonna question it. Everyone's gonna say L chest, and yeah, you're right. My last warm-up set is gonna be 135, working up to a weight of 145 for only 2 or 3 reps. Again, I'm not very strong. Now that our warm-up's finished, we're gonna go ahead and slide the last weight on. Right before any top set, it's a good idea to fight the shadow people around you. They live in your walls, and it's really good cardio. So finally, we're gonna be doing our heaviest set of the day with 145 for 2 reps. I know it's not very much. I get it, okay? Right around here, things started to get pretty serious. I had to take my shirt off. I had to hit the chug jug. And now you're gonna see me doing 3 sets of 6 reps with 135 pounds. I like to take some time after the second or third set, really just think about your life and ponder all the mistakes you've made over the last decade. And now we do some shoulder press. I'm using 40-pound dumbbells here. I like to stand because it engages my core a little bit more, and I like to squeeze out somewhere around 8 to 12 reps. I get about 8 here because I haven't eaten all day, and I really haven't been training much around the holidays. I'm gonna work on my horrible chest a little bit more with some incline dumbbell press. 65 pounds here, 3 sets of 8 to 10 reps. Now you're going to want to make sure that some of the weight slides off the dumbbell mid-set so it scares you harder than the Five Nights at Freddy's jump scare did when you were in third grade. After your near-death experience, you should make sure that your head won't get crushed this time. Once that step is complete, you can go ahead and start the exercise. I always want to make sure that I keep my shoulder blades back and down so that my chest is engaged as much as possible. Thank you. before your next set, you're going to want to make sure that the weight doesn't fall off and crush you. Or make sure that it does. I don't know. I don't know what you're into. Now we're going to be getting into some tricep pushdowns. I always find this exercise a little bit awkward, maybe because my arms are long, maybe my position's not right. I've always tried to follow Athlean X's advice, getting your knuckles pointed to the ground. It seems like it does a better job engaging my triceps than it normally would. I know Jeff is a little bit controversial nowadays, but I think his advice is generally pretty sound. Next, I'm going to be doing one of my favorite exercises, the dumbbell lateral raise. I always keep lateral raises really light because I don't like the stress on my elbows. Here I'm only using 10-pound dumbbells. I like to do 3 or so sets where I get pretty close to failure on these, so I end up doing between 15 and 20 reps most days. I feel like it gets a really good pump, and I really like the progress that I've made in my shoulders. When you're doing lat raises, you're going to want to make sure that you look at the camera as often and as awkwardly as possible. Because yeah, the camera's going to move, keep looking at it, keep watching it. Oh my god. And that's going to be the last set of the day. So to close today's videos out, I'm going to talk about how to take your best pictures after the gym. You ever been scrolling on Instagram or TikTok or whatever the kids are into nowadays, and you come across a picture that makes you go, whoa, that guy is huge? It's probably because they spend a lot of time working on their posing, lighting, and angles, or even just editing their photos. So take a look at this. Pretty unimpressive, right? It looks like I hardly even work out. There's not much definition or muscle on my frame. Now look at this. As soon as I start properly posing for the picture, there are some pretty noticeable differences in the way my body is perceived. My abs are more visible, my waist looks a little bit thinner, and my chest and shoulders look much bigger and more defined. How you pose is going to make a pretty enormous difference in any picture view, so make sure you flex those muscles loud and proud. Another thing that's going to make a really big difference in your gym pics is the lighting. You're going to want to try and get directly under some bright lights for the best results. You're going to see some nice shadows, and it's going to accentuate your muscles really nicely. Finally, try and experiment a little bit with camera angles. Just move your camera around to find which muscle groups seem to really pop on camera. I usually stand straight on from the camera or at a slight angle if I'm trying to show off my shoulders. You can also position the camera to avoid showing areas that might not be as developed as you want. This is why you're absolutely never going to see me posting my calves. Those are just a few things that you can keep in mind when you're trying to take pics to show off that sick pump. Alright, that's going to be it for today. If you want, you can like and subscribe, and I'd love to hear your thoughts on this video so I can decide whether I should make more of these. Have a great day!